believe me, there would be no chance in hell that he would be our Prime Minister come October the 19th. It is our job, it is our responsibility to talk to our friends, to talk to our neighbors, to talk to our co-workers, and tell them the truth about what Stephen Harper wants to do to Medicare. That is completely dismantle a system that Canadians are immensely proud of and actually defines us. I know that the people here today are supporting Medicare. I know that all of you, not only you, some of you work in healthcare, but we're all consumers. We are all users of the healthcare system. And we know the struggles that it's facing, and we know that the struggles are going to get worse. We see bad cuts in hospitals across the province as they try to take our services out of hospitals, move them into communities where they can privatize them in clinics, all under the guise of better care. It's not better care. We need to stand up for our hospitals. We need to stand up for seniors and long-term care and demand standards for them. We need to demand better. We need to demand pharmacare. We need to demand a long-term care strategy in this country. So I thank everybody for coming today. I thank you, UNIFOR, and our 310,000 members from across the country stands together with you in this fight for Medicare. We will be there on October the 19th to send a message to the Harper government that we got enough. Thank you, Christian brothers.
Mary Shortall, the president of the Newfoundland and Labrador Federation of Labor.
And I say health care, you say?
We care!
Health care!
We care!
Here's what happens when Stephen Harper cuts funding to the provinces. Our progressive conservative government, under Premier Paul Davis, has just announced that they're seeking public-private partnerships or pick the public's pockets, like my brother CUPE says, in long-term care in this province. And they're an insane fast-track method to get this done before the election in November 30th. But we have a message. This government has no mandate to do this. This government decided to kowtow to the interests of business and the rich and to do this prior to the election to try and shed the country. The Newfoundland Labrador Federation of Labor joins with all of you to say very loudly, very clearly, we do not support any measures by any government that puts profit before people. The Newfoundland and Labrador, just like the citizens of Canada, have said they want public health care, they want it, they deserve it, and they deserve quality public services along with that. Workers in long-term care, workers in the healthcare sector, all workers deserve decent wages, benefits, and working conditions. Our economy needs those good jobs, and our country was built on a caring support for each other, and we need to continue this. Cutting public services, privatizing healthcare, P3s will not do it. It won't save money, we already know this. It won't provide better services. Putting people again before profit, putting profit first, benefits only the wealthy, and we know that. So we have a strong message to send Premier Paul Davis, any members running for the next election in Newfoundland, Labrador in November, and government in Ottawa, our public sector is not for sale. Our public services are not for sale. Our health care is not for sale. We need to stop this outrageous move. Government needs to do the right thing, and we're going to do the right thing. We're going to kick ass all the way to the polling
Sandra Azocar, who's here from Alberta. She's the director of the Alberta Friends of Medicare.
Thank you. Thank you so much for coming out. I have another chance for you. We want Medicare, not Harper Care.
We want Medicare, not Harper Care.
We love Medicare.
We're excited as we go marching down to send a message to the community today. I want to thank you for coming out. Drag your voices through the work that the Canadian Health Coalition and its provincialized allies carry out every day, each and every day, to promote the expansion and protection of our Canadian healthcare system. Politicians politicians not oversee the light, but they do feel the heat. And we're most definitely in a position to make those who want to represent us federally on October the 19th. We want to send them the message and make them feel the heat that we will vote to reclaim the values of equity that for over 50 years guided the creation of our Medicare system, a system that makes Canada a great country. On a personal note, I want to bring you greetings from a province that after 43 years of conservative government, finally voted for change. On May 5th, Alberta voted for a more caring and fair province. We voted for health care. We voted for the public good. And I was there to say that we're here because we believe health care is a right, not a privilege. By refusing to negotiate a new health accord, the federal government abdicated its responsibility in health care and turned its back on the provinces as it will struggle in the upcoming years to pick up the pieces. By failing to provide federal leadership on health care, they have created a fragmented system where there are no national oversight or standards. We have the Canada Health Act that outlines the principles of our Medicare, yet we have a federal government that does not enforce these principles. We have a federal government that has failed to stop the growth of private for-profit health care across the country. Canadians know that if we lose our public health care, most of us would not be able to afford care. We need to put the health of society, the well-being of all at the forefront of how government makes decisions. Our health care may not be perfect, and there's definitely room for improvement, but it's a solid foundation from which to continue building, expanding, and improving. Health care is the most fundamental and crucial service any government can provide its people. It is a very simple message that the premiers can take to the federal government. Reinvest in health care. Canadians want a Medicare system that is publicly administered, comprehensive, universal, portable, and accessible. Healthcare that is based on need, not ability to pay. Thank you.
Thank you very much to all of today's speakers.
And where's Mary Clark?
Mary Clark is the head of the Newfoundland and Labrador Health Coalition, and she's also going to be the head of our march today.
We want health care, not heart care. We want health care, not heart care. baby.
Get to hold him up, boy. Get to hold him up. What's the chances to be an ambulance behind you?
What do we want?
Make noise, make noise.
Here. testified that our health care is not for sale.
Right on.
And we need to get the federal government to the table so that they're paying their share so that we can provide the health care that the people of this country deserve. We need to send a message to Stephen Harper. And that message is health care is the number one priority for the people of this country. And if you, as Prime Minister, is not going to do your part, then our objective come the federal election in October is to make sure that you're no longer there to make the decision. Upcoming in the next federal election, that they're voting for health care, that they make sure they ask their candidates what their position is on federal transfers. We just heard this morning that it's $43 billion that we're going to be shorting in 8 years.
Yay! Yay!
25 by 25. The share that the federal government needs to transfer to the provinces so we can make sure our mothers, our fathers, our brothers, our sisters, our children, our grandchildren, and even future generations have a public health care system in this country that we can be proud of as Canadians. Thank you all for coming, and let's keep the momentum going. Vote for health care in the federal election. Thank you.